Welcome to the town of Sestrarietsk. Welcome to the town of Sestrarietsk. Welcome to the town of Sestrarietsk. The name of the town is very, very hard to pronounce, and I think this is my 20th. Welcome to the town of Sestrarietsk. The name of the town is pretty hard to pronounce, and I think I needed like 100 times to pronounce it right. But it's I think 38 kilometers away from St. Petersburg city center, and it's right now, after the first half an hour we spent here, super beautiful. If you look around here, there's already a very nice lake and a fountain, and the building on the other side there is today a toolbox factory, and back in the day it was a ammunition factory. I think it was founded by Peter the Great in 1710, or between 1710 and 1720, and it was used to be a ammunition factory. And yeah, today it's a tool factory. I don't know what they what kind of tools they manufacture there. See the the seagull, there it comes. So we will have a little walk and stroll around this city and see how many real Sestrarotnikens we can find there, if they pronounce like this, because yeah, it seems to be very calm and very peaceful and beautiful here. All right, no big blue shark here. I thought he or she, I don't know if it's he or she, I knew the difference actually, but I think it's a, oh, there is coming. All right, I think the difference was, I think one of the males have a green head, and the females have another color. So yeah, I think this one might be a male, and the one who was probably about to attack us is a female, but I'm not sure yet. Oh, there's here again. And this, of course, those houses are what you can find in Sestrarietsk as well. Very old Soviet buildings. And the total contrary on this is very new Soviet buildings. All in all, Sestrarietsk is a very peaceful place where we can calm down a little bit and reboot yourself from your busy and hustle in life in St. Petersburg. I think if the weather is way more better and a little bit more sunny, then you can enjoy the city or this little town even more. Bring cash with you, because there are a couple of places where you can't use your credit card. That's why you need cash. I mean, if you're from Western countries like Germany, you're pretty used to use cash, but for Russia itself, except for the fact if you're on a little town right now, it's very uncommon to use cards anymore. They are way more further than all the Western world is when it comes to card paying, Google Cash, Apple, Google Cash, what Apple?
It's new.
What's this, like the Krafta newspaper?
This is a communist party's newspaper, which is called The Truth. You should translate it in English. recent.
Oh wow, I thought it's like from the 90s or so.
No.
Oh yeah, really, there's like, let's say like 2019.
Yeah.
Actually, this looks like very, very 90-ish. Oh, but this is 90. Oh, this is also new. This is even, yeah.
It's still being published.
Yeah, all right. So this is propaganda, right?
Oh, no.
But communist parties.
Yeah, there are a few parties.
All right.
In Russia, so it's not propaganda.
Oh.
It's just.
What does it say? The American thing.
Oh, it's like Russia. I don't know.
What does it say?
I don't remember the translation of it itself.
Yeah. All right. So.
Yeah. Thank you. That's amazing. I feel really confused.
Well, so in Sestorovsk you also can find much of a Russian communism party. Russian communism is still alive. It's not dead. Да? Да.
Полиция бросается на демонстрантов, и вы узнаете те же американские приемы, ту же полицейскую технику.
Nothing too.
It's actually a store, I think.
Yeah. What can you buy in there? Some corpses. And now we're in a supermarket where we're watching out for biscuits. They are only available in this supermarket.
Ba-da-da-da-da. My favorite.
Leibniz, yeah. Leibniz butter cakes. It's from Germany. In the commercial it says Leibniz, the only cookie, butter cookie with the 52 bytes. Which is meant they it has some kind of zigzag on the outlines of the cookie itself. But it doesn't seem like they have, maybe they are at like the, you know, some for baking and stuff. Mmm. Oh, here. There's like, yeah, but maybe it's here, because here are also cookies, or maybe ask her. Unfortunately, those cookies are not available here. So the cookie hunt begins. What was the name of the cookies in Russian?
Savoyardi, but it's
Savoyardi.
Kind of French name.
All right, so let the cookie hunt begin. Well, in Russian joint on the countryside, if you order some dinner, so what's going on, friend? See? There are stray cats everywhere. And they're so hungry that we are about to give them a little bit. See? Some fish. And it's a very cutie cat. We don't know right now if it's a boy or a girl. Yeah. Пожалуйста, братан. Oh, братина.
Сестра. Сестранка.
Сестранка. See? Enough? See, there's your... She's coming. Go away. Okay, let's do it. There's another piece, but that's it. That's all I have, little friend. there are actually so many of them stray cats here. So you had some fish, you had some chicken. The parsley, actually you don't want the healthy parsley, you don't like. Yeah, the camera is of course not edible, but that's everything. So actually these cats here are a gang, see? They are like begging for food at this little booth. I think back in there are also cats, I think. See, that's our house cat for right now. So yeah, we got everywhere our cats in this place here, and it's a begging gang.
House in a dog house. In a dog house. There was a dog room. In the dog room, there was a dog wardrobe. In the dog wardrobe, there was a dog dress.
Actually, the plate of the house looks like somebody would live there. Somebody living here? It smells like fire. Oh yeah. Shit. Local. Yes, locals. Probably. Oops. So you get made and get slaughtered or something. And it's where this name. What's his name? Sviestorias is absolutely nobody, just like sometimes one or two cars. And this is where only the coolest and richest and fanciest people are living. They don't live in St. Petersburg city center. It's the same like in Germany. They live totally private in the outskirts, in their big nice mansions. I mean, got taste. Doesn't look very, very. I would say it doesn't look somebody hasn't got taste or so. It's very nice actually. It's made out of. This is like a wooden house. It looks pretty cool. It's not locks. There are like. Long lumber. It's actually cool. Very peaceful living so close to the sea, and especially during nice weather. I could imagine worse places on earth. It's also very nice architecture there. Unfortunately, I won't ring their bell and ask for. For a little permission to come inside their place. And this is also a very, very big one, but I don't think this has something to do with any rich oligarch. I think this is more like not industry, but maybe for, I don't know, this looks like an old barracks or so. Yeah, this looks like an old barracks or so. And right now we are entering a forest, which was suddenly appeared on the map, and this is, and I think they built all this area where are the buildings for the very rich people are living and having their houses. They got, I don't know, it seems like they got a little private forest here. And of course we saw a smaller one earlier before, and see, there are like people everywhere, like, you know, I wouldn't call them gopniks, but you know, They seem like they're having
they're a... They're picking up mushrooms.
Oh, yeah, really? Mushrooms, I thought they're picking up some bottles of vodka. So, yeah, it's a super, super calm forest here right now. And can you imagine this is only 30 kilometers away, or what was like 38 kilometers away from the city center? Yeah, this is very, very peaceful here. Yeah, they're all, yeah, they're searching for mushrooms, I guess.
Mm-hmm. For berries?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, this is raspberry.
Yeah, but not from here. You won't take them from and eat them from here. Because, I don't know if you're familiar with diseases from dog shit, and especially of all those straying cats here. But yeah, this is very home feeling for me right now, because in Germany we have many, 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 many woods, and the smell here is very nice. And no, it's not dog shit and feces from different animals. Well, oh yeah, but yeah, that's why they're collecting them. Yeah, I don't know. Double it in. And right now we have to choose which way we go, which way we go, which way we go, which way we go. You got so many, many, many options which way to go. And now I'm dizzy. Wow, I'm really dizzy right now. So, so we're gonna go this way. But I'm pretty sure it won't lead us to the beach, because we are searching for a beach right now. I think it isn't a real beach, but it's more the seashore, and I think this is also the seashore when you are coming from with the ferry from Helsinki. And a special gift when you come to this place. And a special gift if you come to this place, get some socks. I don't know what's on there. Is this a babushka? Or is this like a dragon? It seems like the breasts are little eggs.
No, it's an owl.
Oh, it's an owl. Alright, it's an owl. So, yeah. It was close, right? So, all in all, it's very, very nice and peaceful here. Of course, the ride here, we came by taxi, and of course, if you come from anywhere else than Eastern Europe, then you pay for a taxi ride. It was an hour, actually, and the price was only 780 rubles, and I think this was around about 8-10 euros or 11 euros, which means $13 or so. But you also, oh, yeah, there's the sea. But you can also come by bus and by metro station, depends of course where you're going. Or you split it up and drive to like the last metro station in the north. And with the blue line, the M2. I also will explain this on my metro hopping video, and then take a taxi for I don't know, like 200 rubles less or so. But all in all, it's super comfortable to ride with a taxi here. But for the show, we will get home by bus, which is not taking that much longer. I mean, it's only 20 minutes more or so, and of course it's super, super cheap, the bus ride, including the metro, is I think like 120 rubles or so. So absolutely nothing, like a euro and 80 or so, or 2 euros. And right now, after, I mean, like, it's super crazy actually, because this is no park. This is really, it seems like a huge forest here. So you really have to step outside, and then you're again having all this this mansions here, yeah, So also here on this side you have all the mansions again, but it's the same in Germany as well, where very very bitch rich people are living. They are on the outside, and now you're as close as we get to the sea. It gets a little bit more windy, and I have to excuse myself for the noises, but yeah, this looks right now pretty nice. And this is it. It has the character of the North Sea, I would say. I remember this when I was a child. We were often at the North Sea, and it's super nice right now. It smells super nice. It has I don't know. There are many. I remember many things back in the day when I was a child. So all in all, this looks very beautiful, and I can imagine how cool it is when it's very nice weather here, and you bring your friends, your family, or whatever, and just hang out here, and have a nice barbecue or a nice rave. I don't know if you bring your sound system out here. I think this would be a very nice rave. In Kiev, there is near the Hydro Park, there is a place, a little island where they had a rave. I think it was the Ostrov Island or Ostrov Festival. So it was also pretty similar, and they made a rave there. Yeah, but all in all, the wind noise will disturb this again. Wow, look at this lonely island back there. You know that island? Ah, yeah, she's right. Maybe it's Kronstadt. It's cold.
Cool. Yeah, incredible.
I think we can cross there. Oh, this seems like a swamp here. Yep. We can't cross there because this is a swamp, and I think we can cross. I think we can go there, and then we can cross the other side. Oh. So back there, this little island is probably Kronstadt. So this is the end. Probably the end of the vlog for this place. I even can't pronounce it every time. This name is just like it's beating the sh out of me, really. But I think it's a beautiful end vlog. But what do you say? It's pretty warm. Really? Oh, really? She's right. It's really warm. Much more warmer than the wind and the temperature itself. I think we have almost just, there's maybe 14 degrees left right now, or 13. and my shoes are starting to look very muddy. But yeah, I think I didn't promise too much. This was the day of Rui Boot after over 1 week of city hustle and city trouble, and I think there's not much left to say. Seems like there's blood, right? Yeah. But we have to go around. Like here, you know. And of course, it's absolutely normal have like a horse here. Yeah. But I was a little bit confused anyways, because I've seen the footprints of the hooves of the horse before. Oh, wow. Also the dog is want to catch some horse today. So, not horse, you know, horse. Okay, actually I promised to take the bus back home to the city center. Well, quelle surprise! We got a little promo code for our last Yandex ride. Yandex is the Russian version of Uber, because there's no Uber available in St. Petersburg as well. Yeah, it is, but it doesn't work. So it refers you to Yandex. And on our way back now, straight on the Autobahn, there was a police control. And of course, we were in. And our taxi driver, we don't know, of course, what's going, or what went wrong there for real. But 10 minutes or 15 minutes after they took him out, he came back to the car and said, like, yeah, I have to kick you out of my car because I can't move it anywhere. The police said, dude, you can't drive further anymore. So they dropped us on the Autobahn right now, and we got to walk straight into the city. I don't know, it's like 20 kilometers left now, so we try to find the next metro station. And yeah, I have nothing to add to this whole thing. And yeah, St. Petersburg radio over.